From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. New developments in the case of the Arundel father accused of murdering his infant son. Gordon Collins Founce is now charged with murder following the death of his 10-week-old son, Ethan Henderson. The court affidavit says Collins Founce squeezed his son's head between his hands and then threw him onto a chair. Ethan's neck reportedly snapped back, sending him into a coma. Days later, he was taken off of life support. The Department of Health and Human Services can't speak to specific cases, but officials there say there are some clues about abusive homes.
It's very difficult to break a bone when you're a baby. And so if they're not walking, then something forced that bone to be broken.
Court records say Collins Founce admitted to breaking Ethan's arm at 4 weeks. Cahill Lowe says professionals who work with children are required by law to report abuse, even if it's just based on suspicion. Voters in Auburn now have decided whether they want a recount regarding yesterday's school budget vote. Right now, the vote tallies are 349 to 344 in favor of the budget. The city will conduct a recount if 10% or 70 of Tuesday's voters' requests, one between now and Tuesday. The vote was so close that at first officials thought it was a tie. The bottom line on the school budget is nearly $36 million, and it includes a tax increase of almost 6%. A high school student is working to make sure the air is a little cleaner at Old Orchard Beach this summer. Wednesday, crews put up signs asking beachgoers to keep their tobacco products away from the shore and sand. The effort was spearheaded by Hattie Simon, an Old Orchard Beach resident and sophomore at Thornton Academy. She says that she and three other girls worked for years to get city officials to pass a tobacco-free beach resolution. Wednesday, their hard work paid off.
Even though this is voluntary, it means that people will be able to be more comfortable going up to somebody and saying, hey, maybe you want to, you know, not smoke here and not smoke those cigarettes and take your tobacco products away from the beach.
The next week, Hattie will travel to Washington, D.C. to an accept award from the Campaign for Tobacco-Free Kids. Despite Wednesday's rain, some students braved the elements to take part in a national program designed to make them healthier. Wednesday was the first ever national bike and walk to school day. Students at Lincoln Middle School in Portland took part, although there were more walkers than bikers. The city of Portland also took today to install Portland walkways, which identify safe routes for children and parents to walk or bike to school.
The students really know what it means to be environmentally conscious. So to walk or ride a bike means that they're not driving a car and adding to, you know, the depletion of the environment.
When I walk, I know that you're like getting healthier and all that stuff because everybody always tells you that. I mean, you don't really feel it at the moment, but I know in my mind that you are.
Lincoln Middle School is also a 5210 school, a national program designed to prevent childhood obesity. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sib. We'll be right back.